Hey everyone, I'm Ms. Milkowski, the mathematician, and today we're going to work on using the distributive property. All right, so we are going to simplify this expression, negative 3x plus 2 minus 5 times the quantity x plus 1, and I'm actually going to do it in two ways, all right? So this will be way 1, and then you can see way 2 after that. And actually, if you check in the description of the video, I'll have a link to where way 2 starts if you want to skip that way, to directly to way 2. All right, so way 1, and really all this has to do with is what we do with the fact that it's minus here, okay? So way 1, what we're going to do is I'll rewrite the original problem. So 3x plus 2 minus 5 times the quantity x plus 1. Okay, what we're going to do is we are going to have the 5 take the negative, okay? And what I mean by this is we are going to change this to a plus sign, and we are going to attach the negative to the 5. So it's negative 5. So it's going to be negative 3x plus 2 plus, and then negative 5 times the quantity x plus 1. So if you want to see that rewritten, it would look like this. And then it would be negative 5 times the quantity x plus 1. Okay? And what I'm doing is I always say, like, the number you're distributing takes the negative or takes the sign. Okay, so the reason you're allowed to do that is if you think of something like this, if I had, 5 minus 2, the subtraction sign is actually our shorthand for adding the additive inverse. So 5 minus 2 is the same as 5 plus negative 2, right? And some teachers will want to actually, this is probably actually more correct, like putting it in parentheses so you can see. Okay, so actually maybe I should even put parentheses here. all right, so now we're just going to use the distributive property, okay? So we are going to, maybe I'll use green because you can see the contrast a little better. So I will distribute that negative 5 into x plus 1, okay? So now we have negative 3x plus 2 plus, and then negative 5 times x is, and I'll keep this in parentheses, negative 5x, and then negative 5 times positive 1 is negative 5. Awesome. All right, now for our next step, because this is addition, we are actually just allowed to remove the parentheses. If this had been subtraction, we would have had to distribute the negative, but because it's addition, we can just take the parentheses away and say, see you later, parentheses. Okay, all right. Now we have that situation of the plus negative 5, okay? So we can then go backwards because I know a lot of people are used to seeing it with that shorthand. So I will just rewrite it, okay, as negative 3x plus 2 and then plus negative 5x is the same as minus 5x, and then minus 5. Now, if you're okay with keeping it as that, that's fine too. Either way is good. All right, now we just combine like terms. So I've got a negative 3x and a negative 5x, so that's going to be a negative 8x. And then I've got a, positive 2 and a negative 5, so that's going to be negative 3. Awesome. So then my answer is just negative 8x minus 3. All right, so let's try way 2. All right. So maybe I'll do way 2 in a different color. All right. So way 2 is not much different. It's just the fact that we don't pull the negative. We don't have the 5 pull the negative. So I'm going to rewrite the problem. So negative 3x plus 2 minus 5 times the quantity x plus 1. So in this case, what I'm going to do is I'm going to leave the minus, and I'm going to distribute the 5 into the parentheses and then keep the parentheses, obviously, okay? So then it becomes 5 times x, which is 5x, and 5 times 1, which is 5, okay? So as you can see, the difference between this one and that one is this was addition, this was subtraction. So then I kind of alluded to it in this problem, and I said, oh, we can just remove the parentheses because it's addition, right? But we can't do that with subtraction. We'd have to distribute it in, okay? So that's exactly what we're going to do now. So first we distribute it in the 5. Now we're going to distribute in the negative, okay? So this becomes negative 3x plus 2 plus, because when we distribute the negative in, this becomes plus, okay? Because we put the negative in. Because we could think about it as there's a plus minus there, okay? And then we have the quantity negative 5x. That's because negative times 5x is negative 5x. Negative times positive 5 is negative 5. Okay, and then as you can see, we are literally right back to here where we had the parentheses before, okay? And then I told you at this point, so everything after this will be the same. The only difference was up here. Did we do it in one fell swoop with the negative 5, or did we do it in two steps with the 5 and then the negative, okay? So then I'll just continue on plus 2, and so then plus negative 5x, okay? We can just write that as minus 5x, minus 5, and then again combine like terms, negative 3x, negative 5x becomes negative 8x, and then positive 2 and negative 5 becomes negative 3. Perfect. So there are the two ways. And I think it's super duper important as a student that you know you can do it either way, okay? And also as a teacher, maybe you want to show both ways, but it's super important that ultimately you allow the students to decide what way works for them, since they're both totally legal ways. All right, so there you go.
Hey everyone, I'm Ms. Mulkowski, the mathematician, and I hope you found that last video helpful. If you have any questions or if there are any topics you'd like to see me cover in future videos, definitely let me know in the comments below. Thank you again for watching. I hope you have a wonderful day, and I'm going to leave you with the most important piece of advice I can give you, which is when you're doing mathematics, always ask why.